Namaskar. On the momentous occasion of 72nd Republic Day of India today, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all who have joined us virtually and present a program put together by Embassy of India. We will begin the program with the rendition of National Anthem of Bahrain and India, followed by address by His Excellency Shri Piyush Srivastava, the Ambassador of India to the Kingdom of Bahrain, and special address by today's guest of honor, His Excellency Dr. Abdul Latif bin Rashid Al Zayani, Minister of Foreign Affairs, Kingdom of Bahrain.
Your Excellency Dr. Abdul Latif bin Rashid Al Zayani, Minister of Foreign Affairs, Kingdom of Bahrain, Excellencies, dear members of Indian community and friends of India who have joined online, Namaskar. I welcome all of you for joining us in celebrating the 72nd Republic Day of India. My special thanks to His Excellency Dr. Abdul Latif Al Zayani for gracing the occasion. Let me first of all convey my best wishes and greetings to all of you on this joyous occasion. During the last year, the global community has faced major health challenge of our times, the COVID-19 pandemic. Both India and Bahrain are among the few countries who have successfully dealt with the pandemic thanks to the vision, guidance, and personal supervision by the top leadership of our two countries. The Government of India has taken unprecedented reform measures with focus on key sectors of agriculture, manufacturing, digital and health. These, along with the flagship initiative of Atmanirbhar Bharat, will help achieve our target of becoming $5 trillion economy by 2024. Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi, has summed up our vision of Atmanirbhar Bharat, and I quote, "When India speaks of becoming self-reliant, it does not advocate a self-centered system. In India's self-reliance, there is a concern for whole world's happiness, cooperation, and peace." This is evident in India's handling of COVID-19 pandemic. India is, because of its strengths in the biopharmaceutical and vaccine domains, one of the major centers in transnational efforts to counter the pandemic. India has, a few days back, undertaken the world's largest vaccination drive by rolling out two Made in India vaccines, Covishield and Covaxin. As a trusted and dependable partner, despite the huge domestic demand, India has been supplying vaccines to the global community in this time of crisis. Friends, our two countries have had excellent collaboration in dealing with the COVID-19 pandemic, be it the support of Kingdom of Bahrain for our community, Vande Bharat mission, air bubble arrangement between the two countries, or supply of medicines and paramedics to the kingdom by India. This is in line with the deep-rooted civilizational and close ties between India and Bahrain. Our bonds of friendship have been further strengthened in recent years due to regular high-level political exchanges and interactions, and our bilateral cooperation has diversified and expanded. The landmark visit of His Majesty the King to India in 2014 had set the roadmap of our present bilateral engagement. This has got further boost during the historical visit of Honorable Prime Minister of India to Bahrain in August 2019, and more recently the visit of Honorable External Affairs Minister of India in November 2020. We are looking forward to welcoming His Excellency the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Bahrain for the next meeting of India-Bahrain High Joint Commission. Friends, the Indian community in Bahrain constitute a key link in our bilateral relations. It's a matter of pride for all of us that with their professionalism and high standards of work ethics, our vibrant and dynamic community has made a name for itself in Bahrain and made significant contribution to the economic development of the kingdom. This year's Pravasi Bharati Samman Award given by the Government of India to Mr. Babu Rajan for his distinguished community services in Bahrain is testimony to this. This has been possible due to kingdom's rich tradition of diversity, tolerance, coexistence and harmony. I take this opportunity to convey our gratitude to His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister for their vision and guidance in strengthening our bilateral ties as well as providing such environment to the Indian community. We are particularly thankful for the care taken by the leadership and the government of Bahrain of our community in these difficult times of COVID-19 pandemic. I once again thank all of you for joining the celebrations through digital means. Bharat ke 72ve Gartan Divas ki aap sabhi ko hardik shubhkamnaye. Jai Hind. Long live India-Bahrain friendship. Thank you. Now it is my pleasure to invite today's guest of honor, His Excellency Dr. Abdul Latif bin Rashid Al Zayani, Minister of Foreign Affairs, Kingdom of Bahrain, to say a few words.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaykum jami'an ayyuhal astaqa. يسعدني أن أبارك وهن الحكومة والشعب الهندي الصديق والجالية الهندية المقيمة في مملكة البحرين بمناسبة اليوم الوطني 72 لجمهورية الهند الصديقة اللي تربطها مع مملكة البحرين علاقات وثيقة تمتد على مدى التاريخ ويجمع بينهما تعاون ثنائي واسع وشامل في مختلف المجالات ويحرص البلدان الصديقان على تعزيز علاقات الصداقة الوطيدة بينهما في ظل توجيهات صاحب الجلالة ملك البلاد المفدى وفخامة رئيس جمهورية الهند الصديقة. إن العلاقات البحرينية الهندية هي نموذج متطور للعلاقات الوطيدة بين الدول الصديقة ومملكة البحرين حريصة على تطوير علاقات التعاون والشراكة مع جمهورية الهند بتاريخها وحضارتها العريقة وتقدمها العصري إيمانا منها بالإمكانات والقدرات المتاحة لدى البلدين لتوسيع آفاق التعاون الثنائي بما يسهم في تعزيز المصالح المشتركة للبلدين والشعبين الصديقين. إننا في مملكة البحرين نقدر كثيرا ما حققته جمهورية الهند من نمو وتطور كبير في مسيرتها التنموية ونهضتها العصرية وما ينجزه شعبها من نجاحات وتطور في مجالات الإبداع والابتكار الأمر الذي يدل على ما يتمتع به هذا الشعب الصديق من حيوية ونشاط وقدرة على مواكبة روح العصر الحديث كما نقدر كثيرا المواقف المشرفة التي تبديها الحكومة الهندية ومساندتها المتواصلة للجهود الرامية إلى الحفاظ على الأمن والاستقرار والسلم في المنطقة ويسرني بمناسبة احتفال سفارة جمهورية الهند في مملكة البحرين باليوم الوطني 72 أن أعرب عن بالغ التقدير للجهود التي يبذلها سعادة السفير وأعضاء السفارة لتطوير وتنمية التعاون الثنائي بين البلدين الصديقين وأن أحيي الجالية الهندية المقيمة في المملكة ومساهمتها الإيجابية في المسيرة التنموية الشاملة في بلادنا متمنيا للشعب الهندي الصديق المزيد من التقدم والنمو والازدهار.
Thank you, Your Excellency,
for your kind and inspiring address. In celebration of the Republic Day today, a cultural program has been prepared by the Indian schools in Bahrain. Let us all welcome the students from the New Indian School, the New Millennium School, the Indian School, and the Asian School in this order for their performance.
ऐ मेरी zameen afsos nahi jo tere liye sau dard sahe mehfooz rahe teri aan sada chahe jaan meri ye rahe na rahe
वतन मेरे वतन ए वतन नाबाद रहे तू आबाद रहे तू
आयो रे शुभ दिन आयो रे
देश की शान देश की
देश की हम संतान है
तीन रंग से रंगा तिरंगा
अपनी ये पहचान है जय हिंद
तलवारों पे सर वार दिए अंगारों में जिस्म
मरगट तक है तेरी कहानी पग पग प्यारे दंगल दंगल रे दंगल दंगल सूरज तेरा चढ़ता ढलता गर्दिश में करते हैं तारे दंगल दंगल रे दंगल दंगल
झुके तेरे आगे से तेरी गोद मेरा घर है तुझे सलाम इंडिया
तेरी मिट्टी में मिल जावा गुल बन के मैं खिल जावा इतनी सी है दिल की आरज़ू तेरी नदियों में बह जावा तेरे खेतों में लहरावा इतनी सी है दिल की आरज़ू
जहाँ डाल डाल पे सोने की चिड़िया करती है बसेरा वो भारत देश है मेरा वो भारत देश है मेरा
I would like to convey a heartfelt thanks to the students of all the schools for their active participation in the celebration of Republic Day. On behalf of the Embassy of India, once again I thank all of you for being with us today through digital means in the celebration of our Republic Day. Thank you.